In this video, we are talking about isotopes. Now, there's only one thing that determines which element any given atom is, and that's how many protons there are in its nucleus. Which means that we could have two atoms that have the same number of protons as each other, and that means they're the same element, but they have different numbers of neutrons. If that's the case, we say those two atoms are isotopes of each other. Isotopes are atoms that have the same number of protons and thus are the same element as each other, but have different numbers of neutrons and thus have a different mass. We have an isotopic symbol, a way of writing down the symbol for a specific isotope, and the general format looks like this. Here, E stands for whatever symbol the symbol is for the element. Say it's carbon, that would be a C, or hydrogen, it would be an H. A is what we call the mass number, and it's an integer, and it's just the how many protons there are plus how many neutrons. And the atomic number, Z, and that's just how many protons there are. Now, if we know the mass number and the atomic number, if we subtract the two, A minus Z, that'll tell us how many neutrons there are, because protons plus neutrons minus protons is equal to neutrons. For example, this isotope here, this symbol for an isotope, we would call this isotope carbon-13. So that's how you say or write the name of an isotope. You say the name of its element, and then you say its mass number, carbon-13. In carbon-13, the sum of the protons plus the neutrons is 13, that's A. The protons are 6. Any atom with 6 protons in its nucleus is going to be carbon. And that means if we wanted to know how many neutrons there were in carbon-13, we just take A minus Z, or 13 minus 6, and we'd see that there are 7 neutrons in an atom of carbon-13. Now, most of the time, you're not going to see me writing the atomic number Z, because on the periodic table, we'll always have a periodic table available to us, you'll see the atomic number. For example, here. Carbon, do you see carbon right there? That number on top of it, that's the atomic number, 6. So there's 6, we know there's 6 protons in carbon. So tin is Sn, has 50 protons. You know, vanadium has 23 protons. Hydrogen has 1, and so on.